What's going on, everyone? It is the last time that we're going to be seeing the Bleach anime in quite a few months. It's been a long journey and I've been enjoying every single second of it. I don't know about live reacting personally, but I've actually been really enjoying these episodes, really deeping down and dissecting them, really taking in everything it has to offer. So this episode, we're going to be having an hour long special, or give or take 45 minutes to 50 minutes if you take away breaks in Japan and whatnot. So I did hear that there's going to be a lot of content in the second half of the episodes, or well, the hour long second part of the, it doesn't matter. It's going to be a lot of extra content and apparently there's no ending. So we're going to see what's going to kick off, and I'm just overly excited for this, and I'm going to be treasuring and savoring every single moment. And I did hear a bit of pre-warning that apparently there's no Masaki goodness, but we'll see what they do. With that being said, let's jump into this episode. I'm excited and I'm just delaying myself, from, you know, admitting that it's over in a sense for now. So oh, okay, this is new. Hey, this is great. I think it's new. If not, then Bugin, Aizen, hello. This is new, right? Mayuri? Okay. Hey, it's good to see that design again. I don't know. I did like that design. This is so weird seeing the new, well, not the new, but the old Gotei 13 from the Soul Society arc. It's, I trust you. I didn't leave anything else that there was nothing else noteworthy. I'm pretty sure this is new. I'm going to have to go back. I'm bugging. Masaki, come on. I should have at least asked for his name. You should have, to be fair, yes. Yeah, and I'm pretty sure that this part's in the manga. I can't stop thinking about that captain's meeting. I really enjoyed that. That was great. I'm really excited to see what's going to happen in not only this episode, but next episode specifically, because there's some really good animators on. I'm really perplexed about what they're going to be animating that. So, you know, this is great. Look at this. Oh. Bit dazed, are we, Masaki? What's kicking off? Kisuke! The goat! Oh, can you sense something, my guy? Of course he can. Man shook. What's going on? What's cooking? I heard you fought against the Hollow the other night. Yes. And I one-shotted him. Damn, Kagura is a snitch. You hate to see it. Oh, yo! But there was a problem. What was the problem? Miss Masaki sustained a wound from the Hollow's attack. If she doesn't get proper Quincy treatment from your father and mother, there is a possibility the future Ishida bloodline can become tainted. I mean, that is logical. Like, she can't really keep that. What a difficult predicament, some might say. Hey, that Hollow is really doing a number on her, huh? Hey, yo, the hole is opening. Is that a Hollow's hole? It is indeed. Man, Soken taking his time, bro. We're never going to see this man. For Quincy, she's kind of mid, ain't she? Like, she ain't really doing much, is she? She just yells and looks disappointed. Hey, yo, that is throbbing. Just like me on a Sunday afternoon. Oh! Hollows attract Hollows, I guess. And you get bozoed by the goat. That's an interesting effect, that is, for sure. I like that. Like, the hole isn't going all the way through the body, it's just like half in. Kisuke with the plan? Here we go. What's he got cooking? There's no time to argue. Please come with me, both of you. He's been watching, bro. I'll tell you the choices, you have to save her. He's a man that knows a lot, that's for sure. He's always learning. Ooh. Naked Masaki? We finally got it? Hey, yo? Oh, nah. Hey, I mean, look, we take it. We take it, boys, you know? Hey, she looks beautiful as she is. We didn't... Look, I'll take it. Hey, that's a good shot, man. I like that. They really had to brighten that silhouette, though, huh? My name is Kisuke Urahara. I was banished from the Soul Society. Isshin, you should have been... known about it. Okay, so he knows of Kisuke, but never met him. Hurry up and restore Masaki back to normal. Where was man during that entire arc? Masaki can never go back to the way she used to be. Her condition is known as a holification. Holification is when it happens when a hollow soul is poured into another. destroying the boundaries between the two souls. I can't return her to the way she was, but I can save her life. During my research over the past 100 years, I discovered a way to prevent this soul suicide. We need a Soul Reaper one, bro. That's what he's saying. Counteract that, we need... yeah. Shinigami and human. And here's the Gi guy. That man got really forced into an arranged marriage real quick, huh? For as long as Masaki lives, it will forever be passed down to her descendants. While you are in this Gi guy. Does that include Kazui? Interesting. The GOAT, Isshin, he always pulls up when it's needed. Hey, she worth it, boys. She worth it. So, I mean, I'd give up being a captain for a bit of Masaki, you know? Damn. Hey, that's some nice colour palette change, though. Damn, they saturated it, boys. We lost. We're close enough, you know? Tenshou! Hey! Come on! It was alright. It was alright. I expected... yeah. Come on! They cut it! They cut it! Hey, she's blushing now. That's a good sign. It is what it is, boys. You know? And Isshin... so I'm Ryuken with the Walk of Shame. But hey! He's got Katagiri. It's still a dub. You know, it's no Masaki, but still a dub, boys. That Ryuken isn't qualified to protect the Quincy's. Damn. You gotta understand why he stopped being a Quincy. I get it now. Katagiri a goat, though. She stuck by his side. Damn, she looks like a young Tsukushima there. Beautiful soundtrack to choose, too. Oh, that's a good shot. Love that shot. Is that it? Well, I mean, this is coming to the ending of Everything But the Rain now. After that, soon after graduating high school, Masaki left the Ishida family. Also, she stayed with him for a little bit. Her soul was mixed with a hollow for the Quincy's. It was for a proper decision. That's beautiful cinematography there. The Kurosaki Clinic! Let's go! But there was a ton of things I had to learn. Hey, the smug smile! Yes! Needed that. Cute! The smug smiles, I love it. Damn, the figure go hard though, come on. There's still one thing that you've experienced that you don't know about the story. 9 years ago from today, June 17th, the day your mom died. You need to know the real reason your mom died that day. What a great way to end off that episode. Oh, that is fantastic. A yellow rain this time. Your mom, she wasn't supposed to die that day. Masaki, man! She was originally a Quincy. Like a pure Quincy. Her defensive ability and the blue vein was exceptionally powerful. Not only could she defeat Grand Fisher, but she could have done it without even a single scratch on her. Damn, Masaki looked good. Damn, the old art style really did her dirty, man. She looks great. Oh, the blue didn't work. Oh, no. Damn, the blue stopped. It's because she lost her Quincy powers that day. Damn, bro. The glitching? That was so cool. Oshwalin, yeah. It's a Quincy selection process conducted by Yua himself. Fucker, man. What a prick. I heard that Quincy that sang praises of a king who was sealed away. Damn, Ryuken was there too, bro. His mind after 90. It's coming full circle now. His strength after 9. You watch where Quincy is deemed impure of their powers. And made them his own. So he deemed Masaki impure? Ryu's frail mother, Katagiri, lost her life as well. Damn, she looked bad as well! And how Masaki lost her powers and lost her life in battle. Damn, so they got killed at the same time, essentially. How is he able to do that? Is it because he is a king? Who is Yuha, anyway? Is the father of the Quincy's. The Quincy's started from him. All Quincy's have his blood running through their veins. I need that famous Ichigo face, man. I need that. Give it me, man. Here we go. Yeah, look how clean that looks, man. That looks so sick. That looked clean. They did that so right. No problem. Oh, damn. She actually looks sad. Hey, that is a nice shot, that is. Love that. And that's it, right? All right, Zangetsu. Oh, man. I'm ready for episode 13, man. Ain't ready. The blade ears with the scratchy text. I love that. I love that. I mean, I'm just hoping the Blu-ray version can, you know, add a little bit into that, you know? And yeah, we're getting straight into it. So excited. We've seen this banging shot here. Hey, Ichigo. How did you intend to get back there? Oh, there's ways. There she is! Right on time. Hey, she a baddie. I have to say, she a baddie, boys. Come on. Hear me out, man. We're back here. Oh, he's got a normal Shihakusho on. Oh, we still got the Fullbringer thing on, though. Look at all of them, bro. Goons. Damn, they all kneel, bro. Even Oetsu's like, huh? Hey, they kneeling. Oh, it's Ichigo that has to choose him? Yeah. Oh, this is great. Look at this. Hey, he's already got the hair coming out. This is great. And there's Hollow Ichigo, boys. Only took a few seconds, too. I'll personally reforge it for you. What a goat. We're getting everyone's little training thing now. Oh, look at those CGI Soul Reapers. They don't look bad, though. My bunker was stolen, so I'm to fight using only Zangetsu. Then I must retrain myself. Okay. After the battle against Isshin, I thoroughly refined my Bankai. Yeah, a bit too much. Yeah, focused on one thing and forgot the basics. Hey, this is nice too. Hey, the transition. I want you to master Bankai. My Bankai wasn't stolen this time, but there's no guarantee it won't happen the next time. The more Soul Reapers that can do Bankai, the better. Mashiro! Super 9! You gotta do it. You gotta push yourself to the limit. Damn! I would have liked a better camera angle there, but hey, it was a good, this is a good shot. Good shot. A lieutenant shouldn't disobey his super lieutenant. Yes, a super lieutenant. Are the CCTVs off? What's going on here? At this rate, I'm going to take a look. I'm getting a visual. Giving birth to a new Asasoji Jizo. What's wrong? What's this captain creating? Interesting. Hey, I thought this was going to get skipped, so I'm glad that they threw in Amida's family. They didn't need to, but they did, and I appreciate it. Because any... Ah, adorable. Hey, this is nice. This is sweet. See, Amida's not such a bad guy after all. Hey, Soifon, baddie. Come on, boys. Sheesh. We love Soifon. Come on, man. Ah, come on. I wanted to see more of her. Got more of a minder than Soifon. Oh, the great elder, the doggy, bro. Oh, poor Komamura. When you know, you'll know, man. When you know, you'll know. You got some nerve coming back here. You shamelessly donned a hat and armor to pretend to be a human because you were embarrassed about... Ah, oh, I mean, he's spitting. He did do that. How dare you make demands of me. Damn, how strong is the elder, though? You know? Why can't he pull up on the Quincy's, bro? Surely he's got to be rocking some strength. I'm hoping for a good camera shot here. I'm telling you not to disrupt the peace we have. If hiding is peace, then I guess, right? That's a decent shot. I like that. Good detail. Hey, Iba didn't get his shot, though. Hey. Hey, White. White is not caked up, boys. Very bony. This is why Hoden was built on the cliff. A Bankai cannot be reforged without all these waters. Hey, yo. They did my man White dirty, bro. They did him dirty. This is where he's unfucked. Nah, come on. They making my man White look bad, bro. Why they make him look like a child, bro? I don't know how to feel about my favourite character being reduced to this. And I think this was one of my biggest view videos when the chapter came out for a long time. So I'm really coming full circle on where my channel kind of was known. So I'm excited for this. Hey, the baddies, come on. Except for the pink one, obviously. But hey, look, man. Redhead goes hard, man. When I said everybody, that includes you too. Asauchi. Here we go. Man just turned into a piece of metal. Hey. Interesting point of view. Okay, we chiseling. Okay, so she's used as a chisel. Nice. No, me. She creates the lava, I assume. Love that. That looked beautiful. So she is the water, I assume. Oil for quenching, right? She could be the oil. Okay. Surprisingly, I'm not for the Twin Towers this time. I don't know what her job was, I'm not gonna lie. She pulls out a tooth for a hammer, I believe. Yeah, okay. Yeah, the oil, yeah. See? I know my forging techniques, right? I'm saying that the Hollow is your Zanpakuto. Yes, because he has soul repair powers in him as well. So, I mean, I wonder if we'll get a token art of foreshadowing in this episode. That would be interesting as well. The pink? I feel about that. He is your Quincy powers taking the form of Yuha from 1,000 years ago. The foreshadowings. That's a good shot. I like that. They did that perfectly as well. Some interesting camera angles here. Okay. I mean, I still ain't rocking the pink. But, you know, the camera angles are nice here. Oh, I'm not Zangetsu. Ichigo, Hollow Ichigo told you in episode 126 that he was, you know, Zangetsu and you didn't want to listen to him. Okay, now we're in the water. Thank God. Right. It's black and white, though. Okay. I am the source of the Quincy power within you. Are we going to get the snippets of the foreshadowings throughout the series? That'd be really nice. Damn, this is some beautiful scenery, man. Not an enemy nor an ally. But there were no lies in my words to you, except for the name I told you. Here we go. Whenever I taught you how to use your Zanpakuto, I had always help from the Hollow. Whenever you couldn't handle your Zanpakuto's power, when you were truly in danger or losing your life, the one that saved your life was not me, but the Hollow. But you gave him Bloot against Kenpachi. They didn't want you to become a Soul Reaper. That's why I suppressed your true power, which had not fully matured, and became the center of your power instead. You were given an opportunity and honed your strength. You suffered and got hurt. And yet you still continue to travel down the path of your own free will. As I watched you, I could almost hear my heart wavering. Yeah, he became more sentient and he became a different Yuha than the one we know. Eventually, rather than try to keep you away from the Soul Reapers, my heart leaned towards pulling your decision. That would be probably towards the Aizen fight, right? And now I stand here. Damn. Feeling the joy of stepping away from you. No, man. Nothing could make me. Ah, this is beautiful. This whole scene, great. I would prefer a blue tint, but this is beautiful. I like this. Then again, I would imagine the spirit sword. Ah, he cried, fam. No. Oh. Number one. Okay, no credits. Ah, we're going to get copyrighted here, but oh well. Yeah. What you've been using is merely a fragment of your power. Okay. Don't tell me that's all of it that I couldn't suppress. You can now fight with your own. So that's his power. Oh, okay. In that spirit sword, essentially. That is Zangetsu. Damn. Ichigo got a power up, boys. There's the blue. Hey. Woo. This is clean. Hey. Hey, look at white, bro. Look at my man Hollow Ichigo looking sharp. My man smiled, man. Love that. It's a shame we'll never see my man again, but I love Hollow Ichigo, man. Hey, pick it up, bro. Pick up your sword. I was thinking the same thing, that you would complete it once you poured your soul into it. That's why he had to personally do it himself. Because he needed Ichigo there with him. Hey, that looks clean. Hey, the water's evaporating. Damn, you gotta cool that sword down. Woo! Think you can get along? Sheesh, look at clean. Straight clean. Because the blade is me. There's Hollow Ichigo. Missed him, bro. Look at him. Goated. I love that scene. That's a great scene. They did that justice. And they are both Zangetsu. No, this is how it ends. That it? No, it's not. It's not. You have returned, Hushwald. And the subject? Oh, it's a Ryu, isn't it? Right here. Oh, not in the new outfit, bro. Who are you? What are you doing? Traitor. Absolute traitor, lad. Can't trust them, bro. Can't trust these Quincy's, bro. Well, there you go. Close to an hour's worth of just pure Bleachness, and I was impressed. They did everything right. I mean, there was no like big action things, which I expected from these two episodes. But from what they gave us, man, the animation that they gave us for certain movements and certain scenes was just beautiful. And it is exactly everything I expected and more. You know, I'm going to complain about little things, of course, like Masaki and maybe the punch from, you know, Mashiro. But, you know, it's overall, for the majority of these two episodes, they were great. And it was beautiful in its own way. And it hit where it needed to hit. The pink, the black and white, and then going into blue actually looked good from maybe my first initial reaction from. But I guess I'll just leave it to the review, because there's a lot to talk about. And hey, look, man, the opening told us where it was going to end. That's all I'm going to say. But yeah, the New Year's Unfucked toes look clean. So yeah, that's it for Bleach for a while. Hopefully I can get better at live reactions later on down the road. And hopefully, you know, you guys follow me on that journey. But for the time being, looks like we've got a lot to talk about until, you know, the next core comes along, season two. So number one's over, you know, it only seems like yesterday where we were kind of just begging for episode one to come out. It's crazy, but hopefully I'm interested to see how well Bleach has been doing in terms of numbers, in terms of DVD sales, Blu-ray sales, and streaming numbers. And yeah, I'm going to just stop waffling now, and I'm going to save my thoughts for the review. With that being said, though, thank you for joining me on this live reacting journey through episode 1 to 13, I guess. And with that being said, I'm going to catch you guys later. You guys, of course, have this fine day, JaymesHanson. And as always, people, peace out.